So much new music today, but you know that we got to start with Cudi and M. Roll it. Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Channel's name is The Third Ernest. I'm Ernest Adiano the Third. Y'all guys are the Third family. If you're new here and you're not subscribed, consider subscribing if you like what you see at the end of the video, bottom right-hand corner. I would have never thought that these two would have ever collabed. Their styles are just so completely different. But I'm 100% here for how Kid Cudi is going about, you know, making new music and kind of getting the buzz out for what I assume is his next project. First, he had that track out of nowhere with Travis Scott, and then we come out of nowhere with this track with him and them, The Adventures of Moon Man and Slim Shady, fire. So there's really nothing too much to say. I'm like hyped. These are two of my favorite artists. Obviously, Eminem started the channel, and then Kid Cudi just burst on the scene whenever I was like freshman, sophomore in college. So I'm about it. But that's enough talk. We about the action. Follow your boy on Instagram and on Twitter at The Third Ernest, just like the channel. Links down in the description below. And we got The Adventures of Moon Man and Slim Shady. Number one on trending, 1.628 million views. Let's get it.
Yep.
You know what I've been loving? Artists are coming out with their audio, but because there's no official music video just yet, they're coming out with like all these different creative ass lyric videos, and that shit's dope. It's better than just having a stagnant image right there. It allows people to like actually kind of be more immersed in the song.
Yep. Uh-huh.
He's going hard.
Yeah, it's been a minute, but I'm back in it. Y'all ain't dealing with the same bar.
No.
Got a little trippy, then I transition.
Yeah.
New attitude mixed with the pure raw. The night game, your girl called.
Kid Cudi, he's back, dog. Oh, I'm here for it. He hasn't really said nothing but that, but that's all he's got to say.
The night game, your girl called. She like, do me, baby, down to get busy, busy.
Yes.
No dice, chill with it.
No.
In life, feeling dizzy. Oh, having visited the city and I go to war, see me in the day through the late night.
Aight.
Tell him it's a charm, I'm in freeze mode to the gods, can't stop a hero when he in flight.
Aight.
I'm swimming in the light, right? Go and get you some, go and show him something, it's a new thing.
It's dope that like it's got like that. It's got that adventures of like the title of the track makes sense for what he's rapping about. The beginning, not that portion, but this portion he's talking about like being a superhero, and he said, tell him it's the charm in freeze mode to the gods, they can't stop a hero when he in flight. Like he's taking, yo, this is dope. It sounds like throwback Kid Cudi, like Man on the Moon and Man on the Moon 2. Like that's what it sounds like, but in 2020's production style.
I wanna get you some, go and show him something, it's a new thing. Yeah, let my nuts hang.
Yeah.
Rock a top off like LeBron or the Wayne Wade.
Yeah.
Lift off, can't stun a nigga, grow, better get gone, move along. You don't wanna.
Can't stun a growth, better get gone. Like don't even come up, don't be even coming up here with that bullshit. I'm an unstoppable force that will never meet an immovable object because there is nothing that matches the force of me. I wasn't expecting to have to do any kind of like crazy breaking down of any bars on Kid Cudi's part because that's not who he is, that's not how he raps, that's not how his music is made. It's just a vibe.
You don't wanna trip, wanna get it on. You don't wanna act, don't get me wrong. They don't listen to the words in the song. We ain't gotta tell them, we're just getting ready.
Yeah.
See him front. We ain't kidding, if you want it, you can get it. Members of the
We ain't kidding, if you want it, you can get it. Fire delivery. And he said they ain't listen to the words in the song. We tell them that we getting ready for war, but they're not apt to listen unless it's dropping on Activision.
Damn fun. We ain't kidding, if you want it, you can get it.
Fire.
Members of the rage, come and get the song. Next steps of the jet from the lean back. Run them on the world that we ain't packed. Hit them boom, boom, loop them stuck. Oh, you seen that?
Ow.
Tell them where the team at. See if.
I keep on thinking that like it's Eminem when he says seen that, like his voice goes up. I keep on thinking that's M coming in, so I'm like, all right, here we, nah, no, never mind, it's not him.
Oh, you seen that?
Ow!
Chilling with a team at, see a black band, pull up with some drums, yeah, I need that. So crazy, can't believe it. No cams, damn, no filming at all, real nigga facts.
Come on.
Years ago, rehab, all good, help me figure out another plan. It got bad, so bad, nah, I ain't fucking love that, man. Then I hopped out of the new zone with my Louis bag, two story, take you through.
I don't know if people know, like people who are younger generation know Kid Cudi and what his music was about, and he was an addict. And I didn't keep up with Kid Cudi, especially after like Speedy Bullet to Heaven and the one right before that, Indica. Like those albums didn't really do it for me, so I didn't even know that he made it, might have went to rehab. But yeah, the way like these new rappers are like addicted to Xanax and all, and addicted to like hardcore prescription medication, and it's like it's an epidemic basically in the rap world with younger kids. Kid Cudi like was experiencing that on his own. There was nothing else that sounded like him, so he was going through all of that on his own. So he's saying, I went to rehab and I came back with that Louis Vag stepping out. Like, I ain't love that, man. Like, I didn't love who I was back then. That's what the drugs were for.
Man, then I hopped out of the new zone with my Louis Vag two-story. Take you through the dark and the light. Yeah. Got sun, got through new. Back up in the world, it's a day in the life.
God's son got through Jesus Christ, like he finally got through to talk to me. Now it's another day. Now we're another person. Now we're all new.
Son got through new. Back up in the world, it's a day in the life. Hit the blunt and get it. Dude. Raise bars, same song, we did it. Yeah. Hot sauce poured on all jams. It's busy, carry on, smoke strong. Got your mama down with it. Come on. And the game fucking needed something dirty raw. Tell them it's the law and we read it. Yeah. So if it's God you believe in. Yeah.
See, that's Eminem right there for sure, especially since the new cartoon character came in. But Kid Cudi's like internal rhyme scheme and the way that he kind of like slurs his delivery, that's like that signature Kid Cudi sound. Like, it sounds like the words are moving slow, but the beat is moving fast. So you're like, what the, like, where am I going? What type of vibe is this, you know? The lyrics are straightforward. There's nothing to break down with Kid Cudi. That's not the rapper that he ever was. He's kind of just telling his truth and having that unique Cudi sound that he has.
So if it's God you believe in, bob your head and just nod in agreement. Yeah, they say time's undefeated. I'ma be the first one who can beat it. Yeah. I had hoop dreams, now I shoot threes. Got a little green, but I don't do weed. No perp nor lean, that's Tunchi. That's Norlins, fuck Drew Brees.
That's Norlins, fuck Drew Brees, because obviously Eminem is very on the left side. And Drew Brees said some shit that was not left at all. He had like, he came under mad scrutiny. Drew Brees came out and said some shit and put his foot in his mouth, basically, because he backpedaled after that. And he said, I got a little green, but I ain't talking about weed, that's Tunchi. Like, I don't smoke, that's Tunchi, because Lil Wayne has like the lighter and the puff at the beginning of all of his verses, especially his guest verses. And he said, if it's God that you believe in, just bop your head and nod in agreement. Like, yes, I am the God. I am the rap God.
I'ma be the first one who can beat it. Yeah. I had hoop dreams. Yeah. Now I shoot threes. What? Got a little green, yeah. But I don't do weed. No perp nor lean. Nah. That's Tunchi. Yeah. That's Norlins. What? Fuck Drew Brees. Yeah. Snoop deal double. That's two G's. Yeah. Probably spin on paper. Who we since Tuesday.
That's probably two G's, like two grand, two racks, but D-O double G, like Snoop Dogg. The dude is just lyrically capable of writing whatever the fuck he wants.
G's probably spin on paper. Who we since Tuesday probably killed a few trees. Yeah. But the only ones I smoke are the loose leaf. Not high, but I'm your highness.
Not high, but I'm your highness. Like, I don't, again, I'm sober, but I'm also the king of this shit. He said, since Tuesday I probably killed a few trees, because money is like money trees, but also killed a few trees. And we're not talking about weed. I'm talking, the only thing that I kill is this loose leaf, like paper. Yeah, that's what he writes his rhymes on. And trees literally make binds of loose leaf paper. God damn.
Not high, but I'm your highness. What? Secretly, you're my dick. Yeah. But you haters, a butt hurt, bunch of sore hind ends. I was just a poor white kid. Yeah. Now if rap was beatball, I'd be Jordan like bitch. What? You wish you could score like this. Yeah, yeah, not even at half court I'd miss. Nah. I'm mouthwashed, because if I was on the floor, I'd swish. Right. But I cannot lie.
If I was on the floor, I'd swish, because he's comparing himself to Jordan, who's the GOAT, and everybody that's hating just like doesn't want to admit that he's the GOAT when obviously the world knows that he is. And he said, I'm mouthwash, because if I was on the floor, I'd swish. Like, literally basketball, like swish. Like the motherfucker just don't miss. He don't miss. And floor, I'd swish. I'd be like mouthwash. Mouthwash is like Listerine, and you swish it back and forth in your mouth. Oh my God. If I was on the floor, I'd swish. God damn it. But it's not fluoride. It's hydration 2.0.
I'm mouthwash, because if I was on the floor, I'd swish. Fluoride. Swish. But I cannot lie. I got you in my top five. Worst rappers of all time. I lost my spot. Y'all got all time. King of rap, nah.
Yeah, I lost my spot. Y'all got all signed, like Alzheimer's. And if I can't lie, you're in my top five worst rappers of all time. Got him on that ledge and then just let him fall off.
Lost my spot, y'all got all time. King of rap, nah, their words, not mine. Yeah. King of swear words and not lying. Yeah. You should never compare yours, nope. A toll-free number. Yeah. Only way you'll ever have a hotline. Fuck's going on.
A toll-free number is the only way you'll ever have a hotline. Like, literally 1-800, but you call a toll-free number, which is like a customer service hotline. Fucking dude. And he said, king of rap, their words, not mine. I didn't say that I was, but if it quacks like a duck, if it waddles like a duck.
You should never compare yours, a toll-free number. Yeah. Only way you'll ever have a hotline. Fuck.
fuck's going on, man? Yeah, huh? Bunch of half-wits up in office. What? Half of us walking around like a zombie apocalypse. Other half of us pissed off and don't wanna wear a mask and they're just scoffing. And that's how you end up catching the shit off them. I just use the same basket as you shopping. Now I'm in a fucking casket from you coughing. Always stay ahead of haters.
You just used the same basket, like literally from you shopping. Now I'm in a fucking casket from you coughing. Like literally coughing, like a symptom of COVID, but also coughing, like the word right here, coughing, because now he's in the casket. Like he's, what's the difference between a casket and a coffin? Is there a difference? Is it a casket when it's out of the ground and a coffin when it's in the ground? But just the wordplay is fucking crazy. He's literally dead because you don't want to wear a fucking mask. Do you know how outrageous it is that the government has to come in and be like, yo, if you don't wear a mask outside, we have to fine you $250. It shouldn't even come to that. It's not that big a fucking deal. Speaking from someone who had COVID and speaking from someone who passed it to my father who now had it and is barely getting over it, and speaking to someone whose two of his closest friends lost their parents, or at least one parent, to COVID because they caught it from someone who didn't want to wear a mask. They caught it from someone who wasn't being diligent enough in terms of like with the sanitizer, washing your hands, just caring for your fellow human being. Because it's all fun and games and it's all just statistical numbers until that shit has one of your family members in the ground. And then you're gonna be like, fuck, I should have worn that mask. Just wear the fucking mask, goddamn. And obviously the bars before that were political. He's talking about a bunch of halfwits in office. Obviously he's probably talking about Trump, seeing as how he's not Trump's biggest fan. But also not even just Trump, just like the mayoral, just at the mayor level or the governor level. Our governor in Texas is backpedaling so hard because he wanted to open the country, he wanted to open his state for business so that way we weren't like economically hurt. But then fucking cases and deaths just skyrocketed. Other half are pissed off and just coughing, like just like they're only coughing. It's not that big a deal, but just scoffing, like scoffing is another word. Like they're scoffing, like they're looking at you ugly, but the fucking casket just coughing right here.
That's how you end up catching the shit off them. I just use the same basket as you shopping. Now I'm in a fucking casket from you coughing. Always stay ahead of haters. Let them hate, but never let a traitor penetrate your circle. Separate yourself from those who try to pull you down. The real ones never stray. It's sort of like Medusa. Yeah. That's how you stay ahead of snakes. MCs pull out.
It's like fucking Medusa. That's how you stay ahead of snakes. Like you don't let anybody penetrate your circle. And that's how you stay ahead of like traitors. Like the slang term for traitors in the street is a snake. But ahead of snakes is like a homophone for ahead of snakes. Like you stay in front of them. You're not behind the eight ball, but literally ahead of snakes. God damn it, Eminem. Marshall, you done did it again, bitch.
Sort of like Medusa. Yeah. That's how you stay ahead of snakes. God. MCs pull out gats. I don't give a fuck how strapped. You're gonna out rap me. I doubt that. Please, bitch, I'm a house rat. These raps about that cheese like mousetraps.
His rhyme scheme is like just too much. Like I can't even read the words fast enough as he's spitting to like stop and be like, ooh, that was fire. That rhyme scheme right there was fire. That's what's happening in my head as he's spitting. And then he ends it on like a hard ass punchline. He said, I doubt that. Like, I doubt you're ever gonna out rap me. I don't care that you rappers are like strapped up with the gat. That don't matter because you're never gonna out rap me. You're gonna put me in the ground with that strap before you even come close to touching me on the mic. And he said, I'm a house rat because I'm about that cheese like mouse traps. Like you put the cheese on the mouse trap and he's a house rat. Fucking.
These raps about that cheese like mouse traps. Earthlings, I adapt to them. Certain things I don't want to do but have to in order just to act human. Like using a bathroom and vacuuming. Yeah, rapping in the booth.
Just to make the rhyme skit, using the bathroom and vacuuming. These earthlings, I have to adapt to them. Like just saying it out loud, the rhyme is crazy. And right from the jump, as soon as he said these earthlings, I have to adapt to them, like, you know that he's saying that his rap skills is out of this world. He's alien. He's an alien presence in the rap game. And he can't stand out too much or everybody be like, what the fuck? So he's got to like play along, like vacuum. It's like that scene in the Incredibles at the very end where they try to be like a normal family, the first one. And what's his name? The little boy that runs motherfucking fast. He's like in the track race and he's like, trying to keep a normal pace so he's not just blowing him out of the water. That's exactly what he means right here. Like, I got to pretend like I'm not superhuman just to leave y'all, make y'all feel less uncomfortable.
Like using a bathroom and vacuuming. Yeah. Rapping in the booth in a triple fat goose hazmat suit. Bubble wrap and a mask too. And I don't think that's what they meant by trap music. running through ink like I'm tattooing. This is music to be murdered.
I don't think that that's what they meant by trap music. He said, I'm stuck in the booth in a triple goose hazmat suit. Like he's like the scene in fucking Christmas Story when the kid's got that big ass coat on, but he's in a hazmat suit. Cause one, he might be too sick. And two, he doesn't want to get sick literally from coronavirus. And he said, I don't think that's what they meant by trap music. Like I'm trapped in this house. I'm trapped in this suit. Fire. And I want to assume he's saying like running through ink, like running through all these rhymes because he's writing them with a pen. I think that's where the wordplay comes in, but I could be wrong.
Running through ink like I'm tattooing. This is music to be murdered by your love. Turn the volume up. I am fired up like a blunt. Bread is long like an Italian sub. I am drugs. That is probably why your opinion of me's high as fuck. And it's nonstop.
The bread is long like an Italian sub. Like his money's long, he's got a lot of it, like a foot long. God damn it. I am drugs, that's probably why your opinion of me is high as fuck. Like high, you're high off of me and your opinion of me as a rapper is like I'm upper echelon caliber.
And it's nonstop fury, cause I ain't holding them up like an armed robbery. God's my jury, so when I die, I'm not worried. Prayers to George Floyd and Ahmaud Arbery. How the fuck is it that so many cops are dirty? Stop, man, please, officer, I'm sorry, but I can't breathe. But I got you on top of me, your goddamn knees and my carotid artery.
The Avengers of Moon Man and Slim.
Your goddamn knee is on top of my carotidary. The way he says it, like to make the rhyme fit. And he said it's nonstop fury because I ain't holding them up like an armed robbery. Instead of robbery, robbery to make the rhyme scheme. You hold your arms up like you're being stuck up, but also hold your arms up like Black Lives Matter. And he said, God's my jury, so when I die, I'm not worried. It's a different, more creative way of saying only God can judge me. And he said prayers to George Floyd and Ahmaud Arbery. Just the way just the delivery and the cadence.
The Avengers of Moon Man and Slim. Ah, yes, who won it with them? The trilogy continues. Seven niggas, sis, see what's on the menu. Automatic, hot damn it.
Let's get it, baby.
Hope you fuckers understand it. The real for you niggas, come and get these scriptures. Rap God, rage.
Damn, dope. That's such a dope ending. Fuck. I wish I had some kind of nickname that was as cool as fucking Rap God or Rager. I'm off on the adventure. Birds seem flying around. Yo. All right. So I got a couple thoughts on the song. Kid Cudi is fucking back. Eminem went hard. And this is not the problem, but I can understand why people might not like this song. And it's not necessarily because of M's verse. I mean, obviously, if you're on the right or if you're someone who doesn't agree with, you know, the Black Lives Matter movement and the social injustices, like you think everything's all fine. Like, obviously, you're going to be annoyed by what Eminem is saying in terms of the political stance. That doesn't mean it's not fire though from an objective standpoint, but I could definitely understand where there's a disconnect in the song with certain people because Eminem is coming like super heavy, like talking about current events and using his verse for that, while Kid Cudi's verse had like nothing to do with that. I personally like the song because I like the two artists, so I'm a little biased, but I can understand how people think that the two verses don't fit next to each other. But yo, that pretty much ends today's video, ladies and gentlemen. If you like what you see, please consider liking the video, leaving a comment down below. Helps the algorithm catch it and send it out there for everybody else to view who's gonna be obviously searching for this song. If you like what you see enough, please consider subscribing and becoming part of the family because this is how we do it. We break things down in depth. The videos are longer. We give analytical feedback. I give commentary about what I'm hearing when I'm listening to the song. Follow me, your boy, on Instagram and on Twitter at The Third Earnest, just like the channel. Links are down in the description below. Hit up the Discord, also linked down in the description below. And that brings us to the end of today's video, ladies and gentlemen. We will be having a Juice WRLD entire album reaction coming soon. But like I always say at the end of all of my videos, go out there in the world, love and care for one another, love and care for each other. Wash your hands, wear your fucking mask. I can't believe I have to keep saying this out loud and people are still not getting it. Just wear your fucking mask. But that's it, everybody. I'll catch everybody on the next video. Peace.